Taking his time here, Joseph, seeing what the champ has to offer. Don't forget, folks, discover premium apparel designed for performance and leisure. Buy now at one.shop.
Lasiri's utilizing that jab early. He's found a home a couple of times right through the guard of Prajanchai, but Prajanchai seems relaxed. I like the feints coming from Lasiri, trying to mix things up. But Prajanchai, man, you see how quickly he moves across the circle? He's so light on his feet, and his feet are always underneath him. Great footwork from the champ.
The difference in the body types, too, here. The long, lean body and limbs of Lasiri, the shorter, stockier, thicker build of the champion, Prajanchai.
And Lasiri needs to utilize those limbs. He needs to use the push kicks, put that jab out there, and keep Prajanchai away from him.
Prajanchai, nice little step off to his right. Lasiri tries to catch him with the jab. Both men out of orthodox stance. Nice skip up on that teep there from Prajanchai, then to the inside leg.
Yeah, big difference in the teeps though, right? Like, Joseph Lasiri kind of just puts it out there, touches him on the belly, but Prajanchai moves him with his.
Lasiri believes he can go toe-to-toe with Prajanchai for five rounds solid, says I'll drown him in rounds 3, 4, and 5.
If he can get there, that's gonna be the important part. Can he get first those, can he get past those first two rounds? Because Prajanchai's thrown with some serious heat early.
It is Muay Thai in 4 ounce gloves. No room for any error here. Double hooks from Lasiri. As Prajanchai on the outside, good evasion from the Thai. Doesn't stay on the outside long though. Back to center circle, Prajanchai. Lasiri tries to back him off with that right.
Good defense coming from Prajanchai. You can see the way he keeps his hands open and protects his head. I was a little bit worried, you know, how he's going to adapt to those small gloves because he spent so much time in those big gloves. But look at the way he's able to cover. His hands are always open, which is dangerous because of the fingers, but he closes them just when he needs to throw out those boxing combinations.
Oh, Lasiri got the dump on Prajanchai. That will be a confidence booster for the Italian.
Yeah, nice dump by Lasiri. He needs to mix those things in. He needs to keep that pressure on and not let Prajanchai start to get comfortable and start to land those shots. Good overhand right by Lasiri. That's what he needs to do. When Prajanchai starts putting out that jab, Lasiri needs to parry and counter.
Hook there from Lasiri on the front foot. Don't want to get ahead of himself though. Nice catch of that high kick. Rocks the head back with a straight right hand of Prajanchai.
Nice
to
right
end
hand.
The first round, we are set for 5 for the Strawweight Muay Thai Championship of the World.
Lasiri pumping his fist in the air, thinking he did pretty well. He was pretty pumped for that one right there. That was a good 3 minutes for Lasiri, but he's going to have to do a little bit more.
Great, great. Good, very good. You are going to the movement. Move on the right side. Be careful the jab. 1-2, 1-2 is good. You are controlling the match. Stay calm.
Secondo round uguale.
Very good.
I like the advice coming from Lasiri's corner. Got Coach Amro out there telling him that he needs to utilize the jab, pick up the pace a little bit. That was their plan. They wanted to slowly build the tempo of their shots. And there's that jab right away.
Telling Lasiri to move to his right, which he is already doing in this second round. Nice tip to the midsection there from Joseph, the champion with a jab two down the center.
Prajanchai's
the elbow range here, Dragon.
Yeah, Prajanchai's trying to close the distance, but Lasiri showcasing good footwork there. He's got good footwork on the back foot, evades a lot of those shots. See how he moves that way? He does a good job of evading the power shots of Prajanchai. Prajanchai is going to have to go hunting.
Lasiri, no easy pickings. Although, having talked to Prajanchai earlier in the week, you get the feeling he thought Lasiri would be easy.
And that's an important factor, right? You think that throughout this camp, Prajanchai didn't really put the respect on Lasiri, so maybe he didn't train as hard, but I don't think that's a possibility.
Good outside leg kick from Prajanchai, high on the thigh, jab to overhand right there from the champ.
That right looks pretty sharp. That right hand of Prajanchai is a money punch. Nice.
Good evasion from Lasiri. Yeah. Got out of the way of that left elbow.
He does a good job of circling to the, you know, that left side of Prajanchai to evade the power when Prajanchai starts just to rush forward. But there's that. There's that opening right there where Prajanchai catches you as your hands are coming down. Lasiri has to keep the hands up nice and tight.
Prajanchai just shrugs him off. Neither man winning the clinch battle. 1 minute 30 remains. Second round of three. Good jab from Lasiri. Is there a cut here on Prajanchai? There is indeed.
He's bleeding from his nose.
Lasiri may have opened him up here. Can Joseph capitalize? Uppercut to hook there from Prajanchai, not connecting. Lasiri keeping his head movement,
nice
drills
right
on
hand.
Right hand down the center, uppercut to knee.
That was a nice combination by the challenger right there to put Prajanchai on the back foot.
Mitch, that cut's not good. Oh, there's an elbow.
Where's
from Lasiri. How about this from the challenger?
Is it in the eyes?
That's not good. It's a target.
Right below the
eye.
It's
a target.
It's right
painted
below
on the face
eye.
Of Joseph Lasiri to go after.
Oh, Prajanchai needs to come out gunning right now.
You know, Prajanchai said he'd go nasty and target the leg injury that he knew that Lasiri had a few months ago. Now it's time for Lasiri to go nasty and target that cut. That's what he's doing with the left hand.
Look at Lasiri. Has Prajanchai on the back foot. Has him pressed up against the wall, picking his shots.
He's cutting down the movement of the champion, Joseph Lasiri. He continues to just jab away at that cut.
Prajanchai looks shaken.
No. This is Lasiri's round. Uppercut from the Italian. Clinch again. Knees opportunity. Gets the knee off.
Lasiri needs to go to that jab. Go to that jab over and over again. Find those openings.
Got two knees off of the clinch. And Lasiri comes forward again. Again puts Prajanchai on the back foot.
He's going back to that jab. Put pressure on him. Great round for the challenger. Look at him. Look at him smiling. Look at that grin.
I think Lasiri took the second round.
Oh, yeah. 100%. A lot of damage coming from the challenger. Look at this. Let's see if we can find that moment where he opens that cut with what he did. Oh, look at that beautiful uppercut to the hook combination. It was the uppercut. Beautiful timing from the challenger. We usually see Joseph Lasiri start to just get overexcited, but he's so composed. He's so calm in there, picking his shots carefully.
When you're backing away, You're trying to block as well.
That cut is in a very bad place over the eye of Prajanchai. Meanwhile, Lasiri not taking a stall between rounds.
Is it over the eye? I think it's right underneath the eye, right on the bridge of the nose.
I think there's one over the eye, Dragon. Unless there's two cuts, I saw one over the eye.
All right, ready?
Definitely one coming over the nose as well. Lasiri's got a target to go for. We've got an unofficially 19 points apiece after two. And Prajanchai opens up with the heavy artillery.
Yeah, Prajanchai comes out firing. But Lasiri's doing a good job of evading the punches, staying on his back foot. Nice right hand.
Beautiful right hand. Harpooned him with that one. Prajanchai did say Lasiri gets too emotional. That will open him up. Can Lasiri keep his emotions in check, having just taken a round from Prajanchai?
Well, these are the rounds 3, 4, and 5 where Lasiri told us that he wanted to go for it. He wanted to mix in the clinch and start to drain the energy from Prajanchai.
And he said he wanted to drown him. Completely drown him.
But there's a certain urgency that I'm not really used to seeing out of Prajanchai.
It's looking like he's coming forward. It's the cut, Dragon. It's the cut. I know the cut's in a bad place.
Go work.
Yep, here's the clinch again.
Name
yep, Lasiri's a lot more comfortable entering into that clinch. He's doing a good job of pummeling and working his way inside to better positions.
Overhand elbow, trying to open up the money box there, Lasiri. Gets out of the way of the uppercut. Oh, that nose, that eye area bloodied, and Lasiri pops another uppercut. Lasiri showing zero respect to Prajanchai. Prajanchai wiping off the plug.
Yeah. It's bothering him. It's distracting him. Look at the combination landed by Lasiri.
Hook to right was a beauty, and the knees and the clinch. It's scoring for Lasiri. Again, the knees score for him through the liver.
See, look at the hand position inside the clinch. He's doing a great job of finding dominant positions inside the clinch to do this. Oh, goes a spinning back kick.
A spinning back kick. The old audacity against Prajanchai in the third round. Lasiri body shot! The body shot got him. Eats another jab.
Combo.
That blood is causing him problems here, Prajanchai. Constantly wiping his eye.
Bellissimo here.
Bellissimo in the corner. Joseph again, rapid fire combination.
Wow, look at Prajanchai. He seems like something's going on. He's just not himself right now. He's on the back foot, getting pressured by the challenger.
Puts the knee guard on because Joseph's been scoring in the clinch with the knees. 25 seconds remaining. Another good round for the challenger, the Cinderella story.
The underdog story of the Hurricane continues. Look at him picking his shots. He's the one that's able to keep his opponent against the wall, finding good shots for himself. Look at him, going to spin again is Lasiri.
What a round from Joseph Lasiri, the challenger from Italy, in my book, unofficially takes it 10-9, Dragon. I've got 2-1 in favor of Lasiri after 3.
I'm shocked. Look at this. Look at the challenger. And that was a nice little head kick of there attempted by Prajanchai right there, but then Lasiri shrugs it off, marches forward. He's choosing his shots so carefully. And his gas tank, he's not slowing down. Look at that. Nice little two-punch combo. Goes to the head, goes to the body, pushes forward, follows it up with a jab. Beautiful combinations in boxing showcased by the Italian.
Oh, is it on? Is he shaking his head?
You must fight, okay? You do not give up. Can you go on? Can you go on?
He cannot.
He's bleeding. He cannot.
What? He quit on a stool? He quit on a stool, Michael! What? It happened! It happened! It happened! What? What?
Lasiri just shocked the world, Michael. I'm starstruck. I don't know what's going on right now. I can't believe it. He called his shot.
Bravo, Joseph Lasiri. Oh, my goodness. It happened. It happened. Thailand will be in shock right now, in utter shock. As we all are, except for Lasiri and his coach Umro. He made him quit on his stool.
This match was presented to you by Tumi. And now, to present the belt for this match, we have the chairman and CEO of ONE Championship, Mr. Chatri Sityotong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Cost, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes in the second round. For your winner, by way of technical knockout, and new undisputed ONE Strawweight Muay Thai champion of the world, Joseph Lasiri!
Can you believe it?
Yes!
Fairy tales come